I'm here next to my mom's beautiful pond she made in her yard. There's lots of frogs that live here. And it's an amazing place to sit and meditate. You can really feel the fairy dimension out here. All the elves and gnomes, and there's these beautiful bees that are gathering right here next to me, these honeybees. And it's my final couple moments in northern Michigan before we leave to start our drive to California. So I'm happy to share this place with you, and also very happy because today's meditation is with Otter. And this is actually my mom's favorite animal. So that was special that I pulled this card while I'm at her home and I get to share it with everyone here. I want to say one more thing about this pond. When I was younger, I literally woke up one day in the summer and she was out here digging a hole. And she was like, I'm going to make a pond. And I had no idea what it would become, but I'm so glad that she had that idea to create this special space and its habitat for animals. So you can do all kinds of things if you put your mind to it. Such as digging a hole in your yard and making a pond. So let's go on a journey with Otter, though, since that's what came up today. Go ahead and lower your eyes and come into your breath. Just start to notice your breath and how your body is feeling in this moment. And come into connection with a family of otters. I know way up in the northern Great Lakes and Lake Superior is a place that I've encountered otters in the wild, and you could feel yourself just witnessing them swimming around in their playful way, and playfulness and joy are attributes and medicine that otter brings to us. So we're going to connect with some of those parts of ourselves right now. Particularly inviting your inner child to come and witness the otters playing and feeling that part of yourself that can really just be in awe of furry, cute, watery mammals. The way that they interact with each other, how might you, as a 7-year-old, and so just let yourself smile right now with their beauty and their holiness, and how that's a reflection back to us, our own way that as humans we carry those aspects. And as you think of them playing, you can let your heart open up towards them and send them some love. This otter family that's invited you in today to be with them and play with them. Send them some of your love and some of your joy and some of your gratitude. Just like you would if you were 7. And then the otters are asking, what does that little one, that younger part of you, What's a way that you'd like to play more? What's something that would bring you more joy? So just tune into that question as your heart is open and you're feeling their own playful aspects. What's one thing that you could do in the coming week to honor that side of yourself, that inner child, that playfulness? And the thing that's coming up for me is to skip more. I used to skip all the time as a kid, and so to allow myself, even as an adult, even though it's silly and people might judge it and whatever, but to just let myself skip. And so just tune in and be in awe of the answer that they brought to you. And so coming back now, as you open your eyes and come into wherever you are, I'm going to ask anyone who is doing this meditation to please share what came up for you, what message Otter had for you, and I'd love to just know and hold that space for whatever your inner child is wanting you to express in the coming week. And so comment below with what those things are, or send me a private message. It doesn't have to be public. And yeah, of course, as always, please share and like and all that good stuff. If you're watching this on YouTube later, thanks for finding me, and you're welcome to join over on Facebook every week. Every Sunday, there'll be a live video posted. So thank you. All our gratitude to Otter, little cuties, love them, and gratitude to you. Thanks for everyone who joined, and have a blessed rest of your day. Lots of love.